All right, I want to muse on something for a second. It's a question that I have. And it's a question that actually Brooks brought up last week. We didn't get to talk about it on the show, but people have. I'm curious where you guys stand on this because I think my mind is shifting. But there is the question out there of once the playoffs are set in your league, mm-hmm. the regular season's over, there's a camp out there that said, if you didn't make the playoffs, you have no right or ability to touch the waiver wire, sign, release players. You should be banned, stopped.
Your team should be frozen.
It's impermissible because there's nothing you're doing to...
You're not playing.
You're not playing. And then there's a camp that says or tries to say that it should just maintain the same cadence as the regular season and you should not have an advantage as a playoff team and only compete with a couple people for waiver wire pickups. What's the right answer?
Oh, I'm so happy you phrase it like that because there is one. Look, I am firmly in the camp that when you are out of the playoffs, you should continue playing. And I think there are a lot of reasons for that camp and only one reason I could think of for the other. So here's the reasons I would say. One, you're going to be better the following year. There's no doubt. You can't just stop playing fantasy football and really feel like you kept up with it through these important weeks in the real NFL, 14, 15, 16, I mean, where you know, 17, where, you know, I remember back before I was an analyst, when I was out, I would quit. And then I'd come in the next year, and all these players that kind of broke out from here along the way, that were waiver wire stars, I was kind of out of the loop on them. And it wasn't like I stopped watching football. So that's one reason. Another reason is, look, teams have prepared depth. You know, should the team that has better depth be punished when they're in the championship matchup because the other team that's in the championship matchup only now has to compete against them and they were ill-prepared? I mean...
I am on the other side.
Okay, let's...
I've changed. I had always...
You're a turncoat.
I am. And, Mike, yes. I'm guessing that means you're on Jason's side.
A real Benedict Arnold over here.
Let me explain why. First of all, you made a compelling argument, but not for this rule, in my opinion. You made a compelling argument for our listeners to keep playing even when you lose, which, sure, I think that's great. We talk about that all the time. You want to stay up to date on what's going on, but you're really not. You're not playing for anything. You're not even competing against a real opponent in a lot of these leagues. You just get randomly assigned somebody. Now, if you're on Sleeper, you're in the toilet bowl, except for the loser each week is the one that moves on in the toilet bowl. And
and you don't want to end up in the toilet.
No, okay, sure. But here's the problem that I have is I think that if you look at the situation and you say everybody should just compete for waiver wire positions, I don't think that's genuine. I think if you open it up to everybody, people are signing people to keep them away from people. They're not signing them to help your team because you don't care if you win or lose because the season's over and you're not competing against anybody. So the actual motivations, if you say, hey, I want the same playing field that I have during the regular season, I don't think that they exist in actuality. I think that people will only sign. Like, I'm not paying attention in a league I'm out from a waiver wire standpoint. And if I sign somebody off of waivers, I'm doing it with the mindset of I either need to do this to keep the league fidelity of the league, or I'm doing it on the basis of I want to keep somebody that I don't want to see win a championship away from somebody, which is not the motivation by which I sign people during the entire season.
It's still great motivation.
Yeah, that's weird because that
is your motivation for doing it. You've talked about this for years.
Here's reason number one why you should be allowed to make waiver claims whenever you want. Because screw you. That's why. I don't want you to win. If I'm out, I'm burning the whole thing to the ground. You can kiss my butt. Whoa. Tell me I can't add people out the waiver wire. And why should now the number six seed all of a sudden they've now been given an easier path to the waiver wire? Like you're there because they're higher on the priority. They will break the tie. We're supposed to be rewarding the top seeds, and now you're rewarding the lower seeds.
All I was saying is that during the duration of the regular season, you're signing people for a purpose for your own team. You're not necessarily trying to collude against an owner that you want to lose. That's all I'm saying.
And I want everyone to lose.
Right, but you're picking and choosing, and some other owners aren't doing that. So I just think the situation – I used to be in your camp 100%. But then I realized that nobody's actually playing like they do during the regular season in the playoffs. So at that point in time, the playoff team should be competing for players.
Well, also, I think like your league should fix this. There should be – you should be rewarding people every single week. If you're in a money league
– I agree with that. If that exists, then it changes
the equation.
If
you're in a money league, there should be a payout for high score every single week.
And there should be a penalty for last place, so people are playing for that. You know, in our league of record
– Well, last place doesn't matter once you don't have – records, though. The records are figured out.
Sure, but like we've got, you know, the picks that happen, you know, I barely missed Super Philip Rivers. I barely missed the playoffs. And so me and the next seed that missed the playoffs are playing a 3-week playoff for who gets the better draft order next year. I mean, those things should be in all leagues so that everybody can keep playing, and then you can, and then that takes the whiny guy out that's like, you shouldn't be allowed to play because I'm the best.
I think that if you can create systems in your league that make everybody want to be competitive from weeks 1 through 16, everybody, that's the best case scenario for any league, because then it's 100% what you want. It's competitive each and every week. People are fighting on the waiver wire, and then the world's a better place.
Do it, Foot Clan leagues.
So maybe that's just an overarching league creation commissioner tip.
I agree.
Hey, you want to have a cup of coffee with me? Click subscribe. We'll hang out. We'll do it together. Make your team the best.